We begin with the opening prayer. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth, God said, "Let there be light." All together, God, our Mother and our Father, we light a candle of hope to celebrate with all your people as we watch and wait your plans and promise to be fulfilled. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. May we be people who radiate your hope as we worship in celebration today. Amen.
Tonight, I am standing in for Jan Pleger, the chairperson of the World Day of Prayer Committee. For those of you who are not aware, Jan suffered a severe stroke a week ago and is in Oamaru Hospital in a coma. Please pray for her. Welcome to our World Day of Prayer service, celebrated today all over the world in seven regions. This is reflected in our service as we light seven candles. And warmest greetings from the women of England, Wales, and Northern Ireland, three countries which form part of the United Kingdom. Together with Scotland, they are known as the British Isles, which is situated in northwestern Europe. We rejoice that, although they have many things in common, they are a diverse people. Over the years, the British Isles have welcomed people from all corners of the earth, some who have chosen to come, and others who are refugees fleeing from persecution in their own lands. Today, the country is a multi-ethnic, multicultural, multi-faith society. England, Wales, and Northern Ireland are proud of the diversity and anxious to preserve the differences of language and culture, and we rejoice with them in this. We rejoice in the variety of natural beauty found in the British Isles, its mountains and craggy moorland, its fertile fields and pasture land, its rolling downs and spectacular coastal scenery, its small islands. The theme of our service today is God's promise, found in the book of Jeremiah. I know the plans I have for you. Focusing on freedom, forgiveness, justice and God's peace, let us see how this promise can be a sign of hope for all people. Our first song is Sing a Happy Alleluia.
Thank you.
The prophet Jeremiah lived some 600 years before the birth of Christ, at a time of great political crisis. The southern kingdom of Judah had been invaded by the Babylonians and many of its people taken from Jerusalem into exile. The people had lost the land they believed God had given them, and they longed to return, but the future looked bleak. Our chosen passage is part of a letter from Jeremiah setting out God's plan for the exiles. They are to stay where they are and make a new life for themselves in this foreign land.
Our Bible reading is taken from Jeremiah 29, verses 1 to 14. These are the words of the letter that the prophet Jeremiah sent from Jerusalem to the remaining elders among the exiles, and to the priests, the prophets, and all the people Nebuchadnezzar had taken into exile from Jerusalem to Babylon. This was after King Jeconiah and the Queen Mother, the court officials, the leaders of Judah and Jerusalem, the artisans and the smiths had departed from Jerusalem. Thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, to all the exiles who I have sent into exile from Jerusalem to Babylon, build houses and live in them, plant gardens and eat what they produce, take wives and have sons and daughters, take wives for your sons and give your daughters in marriage, that they may have sons and daughters, multiply there and do not decrease. But seek the welfare of the city where I have sent you into exile, and pray to the Lord on its behalf, for in its welfare you will find your welfare. For thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, do not let the prophets and the diviners who are among you deceive you, and do not listen to the dreams that they dream. For it is a lie that they are prophesying to you in my name. I have not sent them, says the Lord. For thus says the Lord, only when Babylon's 70 years are completed will I visit you, and I will fulfill to you my promise and bring you back to this place. For surely I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord, plans for your welfare and not for harm, to give you a future with hope. Then when you call upon me and come and pray to me, I will hear you. When you search for me, you will find me. If you seek me with all your heart, I will let you find me, says the Lord. And I will restore your fortunes and gather you from all the nations and all the places where I have driven you, says the Lord. And I will bring you back to the place from which I sent you into exile. And now we sing, For Surely I Know the Plans. This words and music by Lucy Hull were composed especially for 2022 World Day of Prayer Services program. Anne will play it through once and then we sing it through twice. Thank you. And together, God, our Mother and our Father, we light a candle of hope to celebrate with all your people as we watch and wait for your plans and promises to be fulfilled.
Prayers of Confession. God told the people of Judah to care for the people and the place where they had been exiled. Often we fall short of caring for God's world and God's people. So let us bring those times to God and ask God's forgiveness.
Merciful God, we come to you in confession. We are aware that much of the suffering our sisters and brothers across the world face is a result of our colonial past. We acknowledge this and are sorry that, as a country, we have often put ourselves first at the expense of others. Gracious God, forgive us.
God, in your mercy, forgive us. We think of your beautiful world and how we have taken it for granted and squandered its resources.
Generous God, forgive us.
God, in your mercy, forgive us. Our fellow sisters and brothers cry out to you. We have failed to love them well. We have not loved our neighbours as you have taught us. Sometimes we have not even loved ourselves.
Compassionate God, forgive us.
God, in your mercy, forgive us. God, in your mercy, help us to act on your call for repentance.
Jesus, thank you that through your sacrifice we are forgiven. Holy Spirit, transform our hearts and minds so that we may live and love as Jesus showed us.
Amen.
The people of Jeremiah's time found themselves in a place where they did not want to be, away from their homeland, and excluded from their culture, worship, and homes. There are many people who have settled in the British Isles after they have fled their homeland and culture. In the land of prosperity, there are those who are poor. And in the midst of crowded cities, many are alone. How can we tell all their stories? We cannot. But we can hear voices telling us to listen to what it means to be excluded in England, Wales, and Northern Ireland. So what does it mean to be excluded in England, Wales, and Northern Ireland?
Lena, living in poverty, regularly missing a meal, so that my children might not go hungry.
living in fear because my partner abuses me physically, emotionally, and sexually.
Emily, living in loneliness, isolation because of my age, disability, ethnic orientation, or sexuality. We'll now sing a song, We Are Many, We Are One.
To celebrate with all your people as we watch and wait for your plans and promises to be fulfilled.
These are the stories of hope. There are times in our lives when we find ourselves in situations where we do not want to be. Sometimes, like the exiles in Babylon, we cannot see a way forward and long for God to intervene. When God does, it often is in ways we had not imagined and not at all what we expected. Listen to the true stories of three women who found themselves in living in difficult situations and of how God's plans for them have blessed them in unexpected ways.
This is Lena's story. My name is Lena, and I have helped my son to bring up my four grandsons after their mother left them. My son struggles with mental health issues that and cannot work, so there is very little money for even their basic needs. I used to go without food myself in order to buy food for him and the boys. 5 years ago, my grandsons attended an event at my local church, where they were welcomed warmly. Since then, this church has become our wider family. They help us with regular donations of food from the food bank and have helped us with clothing and even holidays for the family. One member of the congregation is a retired teacher, and he helped the grandchildren with their homework on a Wednesday night. Through the love of this church, we have found a safe space. People who love us and will not let us down. I thank God for the way that he has worked out his plans to bless us, to give us hope and a future through my local church. We all say together, God, our Mother and our Father, we light a candle of hope to celebrate with all your people as we watch and wait for your plans and promises to be fulfilled.
This is Natalie's story. It doesn't always feel like fear when I am with him. Mostly I feel uneasy, like I'm treading on eggshells, unsure of what he is going to do next or what he is going to make me do next. His indifference towards me stings. His unkindness shrivels me up inside. His threats make me paranoid. God is a weapon he uses to control me. I am a shell of what I used to be. When I was pregnant, he hurt me so badly that the baby was born early. In the days I spent in the hospital, not knowing if my child would live, God spoke to me. Stop praying for your child to live. Instead, pray for my will to be done. I said yes to God, who offered only to be present, with no promises that everything would be okay. And yet, my baby is now 13 years old, happy and healthy. My life has been filled with more joy and beauty than I ever thought possible, and I am free from the man who abused me so terribly. No longer do I fear. God has good plans for me. And together we say, God, our Mother and Father, we light a candle of hope to celebrate with all your people as we watch and wait for your plans and promises to be fulfilled.
And this is Emily's story. I had plans for my life. I would go to university and become a teacher. But when I was 16, I was diagnosed with brain tumours and needed lots of surgery. One operation saved my life, but caused me to lose my hearing. I was terrified in my world of silence. All thoughts of a career vanished. I struggled to understand sign language too. I felt caught between the hearing world and the deaf world, fitting into neither. I became very isolated and withdrawn. I wanted to end my life. But God had other plans. He wanted me to use my story for him. He knows the plans he has for me, and I am much better at lip reading and sign language now, although I still struggle to understand what some people say. But I know that wherever I go, God whispers his peace and love into my heart, and I do not need to be able to hear to know his whisper. And together, God, our Mother and Father, we light a candle of hope to celebrate with all your people as we watch and wait for your plans and promises to be fulfilled.
The people walking in darkness have seen a great light.
And Jesus said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life.
God promises of freedom, forgiveness, justice, and peace are fulfilled in Jesus. He is the life-giving light, which even the deepest darkness cannot extinguish. It is through Jesus that we're able to come close to God and discern God's plans for us.
A prayer of thanksgiving. God of the past, the present, and the future, we thank you that you love us faithfully and uniquely. You loved us before we knew anything about you. You care for us in every moment of our lives. You know our deepest thoughts, our highest hopes, and our greatest fears. You know the best and the worst in us, and still you love us. Thank you that you never let us go. Thank you for the plans and promises you made for us, which give us hope for today and tomorrow. God of our past, our present, and our future, receive our thanks and praise, which we offer in Jesus' name. Amen. And now we will sing the next song, Thank You.
As we reflect upon God's promise to the people of Judah, at each pause, feel free to write or draw your thoughts, or simply think silently. For surely I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord, plans for your welfare and not for harm, to give you a future with hope. Then when you call upon me and come and pray to me, I will hear you. As you came in, you were given a packet of seeds. A seed is full of potential and hope. Hold your seeds and ponder. What might God be saying to you? What hope does God have for you and your future? We pray for what is in our hearts. What stops you from hearing God's call? We pray that we might hear God's voice. Seeds need the right conditions to grow. Where do seeds of hope need planting in your life? Where do seeds of hope need planting in your community? Where do seeds of hope need planting in your country? How can these seeds of hope be nourished in your life, in your community, in your country? We pray for these places and situations. May the seeds of hope for our lives, our community, our country, Aotearoa New Zealand, become words and actions of loving kindness. May God, our Mother and our Father, nurture in us the courage, imagination and passion for justice we need as we work together for the personal and social transformation for which we long. Amen. Take these seeds and plant them as a reminder of God's constant love and your hopes. God, our Mother and our Father, we light a candle of hope and participate with all your people in responseful, prayerful action to bring life the plans and promises you have for us. And we sing.
We come to a prayers of intercession. Let us pray for all who are hungry, who do not have enough to live with dignity, and that they may find generosity in communities. God, in your mercy,
hear our
prayer. For all who are abused in any way, whose houses or places of study or work or places of not of safety but of fear, that they may be strengthened and freed from abuses and fear. God, in your mercy, for all those who live in loneliness or isolation, that they may know friendship and community. God, in your mercy, for all who shun from whom people turn away, that they may be included and known themselves loved by as children of God. God, in your mercy, for all who have been displaced, who live in exile and fear of losing everything they have ever known, that they may know God's peace and strength in their lives. God, in your mercy, let us commend ourselves and all who for whom we pray, to the mercy and protection of God, in the name of our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. Now we're going to have the Lord's Prayer, but I'd like to go back to the original, because I don't know the one the what you most of you others know. So see how good your memory is. Let us pray as our Saviour taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Dedication for the offering. Faithful God, knowing that your plans for our lives are good and your promise to be trusted, we offer these gifts in praise and thanksgiving. May they be used according to your will for the benefit of all your people who are in need.
To you, our Lord, we pray. Before the blessing and dismissal, I'd like to thank everybody and everyone who came along tonight and all of you who participated in this service. I think it's important that we do celebrate the World Day of Prayer and the efforts the women of England, Ireland and Wales put into preparing the service. And thank you to Colleen who came and helped me at the last minute. And we do keep Jan in our prayers, please, and her family. We thank you, loving God, that we have been gathered in your presence and shared in worship. Now may we go forth into the world, confident that we are your children, knowing that you have called us by name. In our daily life, may we align ourselves to your will, seeking direction to follow your plan and patience in the waiting. In the challenges and joys we face, may we be assured we do not face them alone. Let us go in peace, hope and love, in the name of our God, our Mother and our Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And a word about the offering. There is a plate at the door. We didn't take up the offering. And there's also an online piece in your front of your booklet if you want to make an online offering. Thank you very much, everybody.